Hello students, now we'll see question number 23. On the basis of valence bond theory, explain the nature of bonding in CO(C2O4) thrice 3 minus. The complex given is CO(C2O4) thrice 3 minus. Cobalt is the metal atom and oxalate is the ligand. For cobalt, the atomic number is 27. And the electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 3d7, 4s2. This is the electronic configuration. And the outer electronic configuration is 3d7, 4s2. We can write like this, Ar 3d7, 4s2. This is for cobalt when it is in ground state. For cobalt in ground state has an outer electronic configuration of 3d7 4s2. Then find the oxidation number of cobalt. For this cobalt take as x and oxalate oxidation number is minus 2. So x plus minus 2, 3 oxalate ligands are there. Then charge is minus 3, so x minus 6 equal to minus 3, x equal to plus 3. So cobalt is in plus 3 oxidation state. It has lost 3 electrons. So reduce 3 electrons here, so it is 3d6, 4s0. This is cobalt in ground state. In the ground state, cobalt has 3d7, 4s2, and in the excited state, it has lost 3 electrons. It is in 3 plus 3 oxidation state, lost 3 electrons. It is 3d6, 4s0. Now, see the orbitals of outer orbital of cobalt. Outer orbital of cobalt, electron distribution is like this, 3d6, 4s0, and this is the p orbital, 4p0. Here the electrons are distributed like this and only one is paired. Next, see about the nature of the ligand. The ligand here is C2O4. It is a bidentate ligand. So it is C2O4 2 minus oxalate ligand. It is a bidentate ligand. Bidentate means it has two donor atoms. When we see the structure of this oxalate, COO minus, and there are two donor atoms. These two oxygen atoms are donor atoms and it is attached to the metal atom cobalt. So the point of attachment is oxygen. And it is also called as chelate ligand because of this ring structure. It forms a closed structure if it is attached to a single metal atom cobalt. So it is chelate. This chelate ligand is stable. So when we see about the ligand, it is a bidentate ligand. The oxalate is a weak field ligand. But because of this chelate effect, chelation, it is strong field with cobalt. It acts as a strong field ligand with cobalt. This is an exceptional case. Here with cobalt, this oxalate acts as a strong field. So in strong field, what happens? Pairing takes place. When the ligand approaches the metal atom, pairing takes place. So 3d6, 4 is 0, 4p 0. Here the electrons get paired, because now this ligand is a strong field, so it is paired. Next, find the coordination number of cobalt. Coordination number of cobalt is 3 oxalate, charge is 2, so 6. The coordination number is 6. Coordination number is 6. That means this cobalt needs 6 vacant orbitals to accommodate the ligand. So these orbitals, these 6 orbitals, they hybridize and form a new orbital. It is d2sp3, hybridized orbitals. So the hybridization is d2sp3 hybridization. So this is d2sp3 hybridization. Here it is 3d6. These orbitals d2d and sp3 hybridize, forms d2sp3 hybridization and accommodate the ligands. And the geometry of this is octahedral. Geometry of the complex is octahedral. Octahedral in shape. And since the outer orbitals are involved, the inner d orbitals are involved, it is inner orbital complex. Inner orbital complex, and there is no unpaired electrons. Everything is paired. So n equal to 0. So mu is also equal to 0. It is diamagnetic. So the complex is diamagnetic in nature.